So, I don't know how much intro we'll get, but we'll at least get to the point where you guys can kind of think about what you're going to do next. So, okay. Jason.
Yes.
So, do you have a feeling for who your character is?
No.
All right. So, you grew up, you're Sioux. I think Sioux is the Native Americans near Seattle.
Might as well be, okay.
Okay. So, you're Sioux, you grew up in the tribe, and your grandfather is a powerful shaman, and you are also awakened or magically active or whatever, your character grew up sort of resentful. He's racist against the UCAS. He really feels like he's kind of an elitist, and he kind of feels like they should have gone the next step and just pushed the United States 100% off North America when they had the power, right? They were the only ones with magic. They, in theory, they could have, with the Great Rain Dance, pushed them off entirely from North America instead of just taking half of it. And so your character's kind of grew up and intentionally became a hermetic mage and left the reservation because of it. He works in for Neonet now. He's kind of disillusioned, he's older, he's done some shadow running, but he's a real citizen, well, of the Sioux Nation. And he's just been kind of doing his thing, but what his primary motivation is that he would like to claim his heritage as Mayan. And he is Mayan, distantly, like super distant, but he just kind of like, he doesn't like that his people are weak and just kind of want to get along with people. And really would like to be more of a Mayan mage and find Mayan artifacts and all that kind of things. For that reason, he's learned Aztlan, which is the resurrected Mayan Empire, has conquered Mexico and some of Central America. And he primarily, in Neonet, in the Magical Research Center in Seattle, he primarily is doing research on Mayan artifacts. But recently, a hard copy location of a magical artifact came across his table, and because it was hard copy, he came up with the great idea of he could do his... So normally you would use Neonet forces to, as a Johnson, to hire people to go recover Mayan artifacts, or really any artifacts, from wherever they are, right? Aboriginal artifacts from Australia, Mayan artifacts, whatever, you would hire people to go. You hired your own people, and you crept into, into Aztlan, which is all Mexico and Central America and some of Southern America. And you managed to sneak into the capital of Tenochtitlan.
I never answered that one either.
Yeah, I don't think anybody can.
Yeah, it's too many consonants. So you snuck into the capital on whatever fake visa and whatnot. Now they really, really, because they're a country that is dominated by their Aztec religion, where they sacrifice people on pyramids and use blood magic to try to influence the world and all that kind of stuff. Because that's like their thing, they really don't want people sneaking in and stealing Mayan artifacts or whatnot. So, because they want them for themselves, right? So you do not have a fake magic license, because that would have gathered attention. But you're just an explorer, and you had to sign a paper saying that if you found anything, you would obviously, anything, well, really anything. Yeah, they don't want you taking anything at all. But if you do discover anything, you're supposed to turn it over to the authorities. Of course, you're not going to. You already had a, in theory, one of the people with you was a coyote, and he was going to use his transport plane to get you out. That transport plane is now sitting on a tarmac, in the capital of the city, and unfortunately he's dead, because as you worked your way into this cave, and then ultimately into the depths, you your people had no problems killing the wildlife that is there. Basically some serpents, some jaguar spirits, you're good with spirits because you're Sioux, and everything was great until one of your troll thugs, he reached for a piece of gold. You'd already promised like a share of the gold as long as you got all the artifacts or whatever, you know, whatever kind of deal would make sense. But it set off a trap, and now you are in a cave-in in a buried ziggurat underground. The reason it hasn't been found was because it was underground and the earth is solid to astral forms. And so you can't see through the earth and you can't move through the earth. But there is small cracks, and you can actually still see the artifact you came for, which is a big fancy feathered serpent, I don't know big, but big gold wand thing. You can sense it, and you can see that it's a powerful focus. But you know there's things in the next room, and you can't get yourself out. But because it's not airtight, you're not dead yet. Because your astral form cannot go through earth, but it can go through like cracks that you can see through. And and you can appear anywhere in the world, but you've got a couple things that are against you. One, if Neonet finds out that you tried to take a artifact of theirs, that it's not theirs actually, I mean it was just in the ground, but if they found out that you were going to take an artifact that they want, that it was your job to help them get for yourself, then they're just
not
going to
contract type deals.
Yeah, they're probably going to terminate your contract with force. And if Aslan finds out what you were doing, then they're probably not just going to be like, oh, no, no harm, no foul.
We'll just take that artifact and we'll rescue you. Here you go. Go back home. No, they're not going to do that. They're probably going to sacrifice you on one of their pyramids and use your blood magic to, or use your blood to power their, you know, whatever rituals. So you can't really let anybody find out that you found this thing, or they'll take it and kill you. But you do have some Shadowrunners that you've worked with, even though they, most of them, are at the end of their short-lived career. And they've either taken working for their mafia family, or in the case of like Laura, she's decided that she wants to become a private investigator and use her skills to help people or whatever. And basically, they're mostly out of the game, but you do know a couple of them, and they're still you could still appear to them. If you've already read the astral projection rules, hopefully, then you know you can talk to anybody you want, and you can travel basically anywhere in the world that you want, that you've been to.
So,
and you have 5 days of food.
On this world, is Aslan like Jesus? Like in The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe?
No, it's A-Z-T.
Oh, Aslan.
Okay.
Quick question. Nope. Is Jason's character named Boy?
Blackfeather.
Oh, okay. It's like Faith Easy for Cindy Boy. Wait, my 10 minutes to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, no!
I was thinking that from the way beginning. Is that
there we go. somewhere where the star is. Maybe.
That's Mexico City.
Right?
Well, Tenochtitlan was like the capital of the Aztecs, which is right next to another crazy huge city that was a thousand, like, well, it started, it ended its civilization around when Aztecs began, and it's called like Tenochtit something, something, something. It's like even longer.
Okay, well, I will check on my food, and then I will squeeze myself astrally through those cracks and go find, I guess it's for the Ramsey's character, who is who?
Sarge.
Sarge.
My character's name is Samuel Bexton. I work for Ares Corp.
Okay.
So when you find Sarge, he's out in the courtyard at the Ares Barracks. The training facility does have limited watch spirits that are assigned, but you easily bypass them, and you see Sarge is just out with 20 recruits, most of them lightly cybered, and he's yelling out commands to do formation training.
Not sure how best to do this, not in public.
I believe the only people who will see you are anybody astrally magically aware, and who you choose to see you.
Oh, okay. I didn't manifest, but I wasn't sure if it was,
I think you can, what you say, and that's why I was hoping you had actually looked it up.
I did, but it didn't, I don't think it specified.
Because
it was manifesting.
People online suggested that only those they wanted to be seen, but maybe that was because you would only manifest in front of people you want. Otherwise, you just wait until he sends them off somewhere and do your
thing. Sure, I got some time.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I,
Okay.
All right, Native American ghost guy shows up.
Hey,
sorry.
Bum. Huh?
A ghostly version of Blackfeather shows up in front of you.
Huh?
If you feel there.
What are you doing here?
Boo!
I need any help.
Boo! Didn't the spirits get you?
No, the mission... Well, my...
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm supposed to be talking about this. Didn't the spirits get you?
No, I'm in Aslan. I was on an expedition, things went wrong, I'm trapped underground. There's loot here, but I can share. But I got about 5 days before I starve to death.
Well, 5 days to run out of food, you wouldn't starve to death instantly.
Yeah.
Well, I want him to get here as fast as he can.
We don't have to. You better start rationing.
We don't know that.
Yeah, you're not there, jackass. So Steve says this astrally to himself.
I'm astrally projecting.
And then he astrally kills himself. And now Steve's out of the game. Okay, so the rest of us will talk.
Sweet.
No,
you, actually.
Yeah. I could probably put some people together.
To talk to you from
as long as the rewards will outweigh the risk.
You have quite a bit of credits as well, Jason.
How well do we know each other?
You've gone on runs.
Oh, we've run together?
But your primary job...
I know my primary job is most
Ares.
Yeah,
so you're like a weekend warrior.
Yeah. It's like, I can get maybe half a week off.
And you have plenty of spare time, as plenty of corporate days off.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't have a life. I mean, so.
Yeah. I can get probably like half a week off.
Well, that would be great. And we have to keep a low profile because, well, you know, Aslan, they're...
Yeah, I know. I'm just trying to think how we're even going to get in. Have you thought about anyone else? Because I doubt I can do this by myself. Or is this something you think I can handle alone?
No, I we're good. You're gonna need help. I'm thinking, what's her name and what's his face? Wait, Mariani. Mariani?
No, Silhouette.
Silhouette?
Yeah.
I don't know who the other players are.
Silhouette and Hammer, those are the other two.
I'm thinking
Silhouette and
Hammer. Mariani is,
different guy.
Just think Moriarty. Just call him Moriarty, and that's good.
Mariani's underlings, Tony.
Gotcha. So I'm thinking Silhouette and Hammer, I'll talk to them. You ready to take some notes?
I guess if I have to.
Okay, I'm at these coordinates.
Okay.
And here's what I know about the overall security setting, what the challenges are.
You really are in the heart of it.
Yeah. So think Indiana Jones Temple as far as, there's lots of traps.
Are you taking the nasal cork?
Things like that.
I haven't sprayed it in my nose today, but
okay.
Yesterday.
I can get the guys together. I think we can be down there in less than a day. But the only thing is we're gonna have to figure out how to get across the border.
I know. I wish I was going to help.
No, wait. What about this loot? I mean, normally those people don't like to get rid of their loot.
Well, you have to sneak it out.
Oh, so we need a coyote to get us out? Do you have one set up?
I had one. He had an accident.
Okay. Can we still use that as a route of escape, though?
Probably. You know, pilot, I guess. Not carrying a plane, just had to get to it.
I'm really good. I have really, really great reflex. So I could probably pilot a plane.
we'll discuss it.
Okay.
See you soon.
Okay.
Where's our sneak of the blue?
Silhouette!
A ghost comes to you.
So you are in your brand new office, waiting for your first client.
This technically is someone who needs help. I'm gonna
all
go request the time off.
All you see of her is she's just waiting for the phone. Literally, at everything she thinks her phone's ringing or the door is opening.
What was that scene from? What movie was that where they're waiting at the desk and as soon as somebody walks in, picks up the phone, be like, oh yes, this is very important, but I will cancel.
What is basically like that. Anyways, so how are you going to manifest?
I'm sorry, Mr. President, I don't have time. Somebody just walked in.
Maybe that's what she's doing, faking she's on the phone every time.
Sir, we're here to connect your phone.
And she's sharpening your pencil.
Of all the hot holes in the world, she had to walk into mine. 3'2", and with feet as hairy as my last case. Okay, so anyway, I just sort of show up while I'm floating blue for some reason.
And a knife whizzes by your head.
that's awesome. It's okay, you're taking
it. Son of a bitch, what are you doing?
I'm getting the band back together.
Well, that's awesome, but you don't have to do it like that.
Trapped in Aslan. I need help. I've already contacted Sarge. I'm out in the sticks near Chattanooga, the Apple Temple.
To Notchet Long.
Anyway, out near Chipotle. And I'm trapped underground. I only have a few days of rations left.
Okay.
So I can make it with you a while. I know it's a big risk. Be careful. You gotta sneak in, sneak out. That whole thing.
Who do you think you're talking to?
I'm just saying, I know that you guys like your.
Well, I don't know about whoever else you're planning on this little adventure, but you know me. I'm not going to be,
I'm bringing in Sergeant Hammer.
Send a wrong member.
Oh, boy.
I know. I didn't want to say, but no surprises, right?
Well, we do need muscles, so there you go.
I knew we could count on you.
Excellent.
I gotta go talk to Hammer now.
Excellent. Okay, I will contact Sarge and get our ducks in a row.
And poof.
Bam. He's immediately on the farm.
My character's in the ducks.
Hello.
I go haunt Hammer.
Okay, what interesting way to.
So Hammer
breaking someone's knees.
Is
right about to.
I'm offloading some stolen goods from the truck.
Yeah, Hammer's probably pretty fancy. Apparently, he's. If he didn't spend all his money on weapons, he'd be doing pretty well for himself. But
I'm compensating for something.
He has formed an unlikely friendship with Mariotti, and Mariotti's kind of moving out of doing mafia stuff, which is freeing up some work for Tony to take over, and he's doing your pick of things, breaking knees, or just, you know, making someone a little bit of afraid so that they pay their protection money or whatnot.
Well, no, how far back you see the...
The Hammer's an up and coming.
The Hammer's
Hammer,
human as well?
This is about 4 years before.
Well?
No. Things are fast paced though, right? Because it's.
Are you human?
I'm more human
than
human.
He's a cybernetic human.
Okay, what about Steve?
An orc, right?
An orc.
Alright.
Mildly
individualized. Oh, yeah, so. I slowly fade into view with a corner of your vision.
Wow. Oh. Hey, don't be sneaking up on a guy like that. What's going on? Nice of you to visit. How's your mother?
She's gonna be very sad when I'm dead.
You got yourself into a fix again.
I have indeed. I said, you know, I gotta get help. I gotta come to Hammer. So I came to you first, and I hope that you were the one who would be able to, you know, round this up. So, basically, I'm in this place in Aslan, underground, trapped, few years of food, you know, the usual. And, there's artifacts here, loot, I can throw in some cash, but we gotta be able to sneak in, sneak out, and need not die.
Sneaking. That's not my strong suit. But you not dying, I can probably handle that. You got the loot and you got the credits. I mean, I like you and all, but you know.
I'm sure you can do an arrangement. And to be honest, I'm sure the other two will probably mess things up. And we'll. By the way, I'm planning on talking to Silhouette and Sarge too. So you'll probably have to punch something.
Yeah, I spent a little time down there, you know. I know a little bit about the area, so.
Well, there you go. You're my guy.
Yeah. Sure. I don't know. What type of. You send in Silhouette more of the details? That's more.
I'll contact her and let her know what's going on. I think I hear a snake.
Okay, I'll like to figure out how I can get down there. It's like. You tell me like your coordinates or whatever.
Give you coordinates.
Shit. Let me round up some of my guns and shit and see if I got my passport in order and all that. You know, I got nothing that can't keep me from popping out of town for a few days.
Wonderful. Yeah, you're my guy. I'm gonna talk to the others. I get a hold of Sergeant Silhouette.
I hate that guy.
So you can manifest for about 30 minutes at a time, but you can be floating around, you know, for I think 6 hours or 12 hours. I think 12 hours a day.
Yeah.
Maybe even just 12 hours at a time. So really, you can like leave and come back.
Have you talked to Carter's character yet?
Who, what, who?
Anthony.
Oh, man. He doesn't know Anthony's character.
Well,
do we know Anthony's character?
I'm sorry, Anthony.
How do you know him?
A couple of you know Mariotti. You've done work with him.
Oh,
he's
Mariotti.
No. He's not the
Mariotti's like kind of my boss. Or
oh.
Yeah.
Way.
So
I
like,
once
you
like
accidentally
a,
tell
more like a mentor.
I know Hammer, I don't know Mariotti.
So, Anthony's Mariotti?
We all know
yeah.
each other.
Okay, I rise up out of the floor.
Like
the wall.
If... Oh, wait, but you don't know Mariotti.
No, we have to get him
to... Well, never mind then, I don't talk to him.
Yeah.
That's how it works.
But Steve probably would let Mariotti know what's going on because he's got to let somebody know so that somebody else can break us some legs. And, you know.
What happens?
You gotta have somebody cover you.
So you can go
to the box. Rearrange your schedule.
That's kind of odd, because that gives him like no reason to ask Mariotti to come along.
Yes.
But all of the three of you all know Mariotti.
How do we all
know? I know the Hammer, I don't know Mariotti.
Well,
and I know Laura Falcon.
Then only he
knows. I don't know any of them, because it wasn't ever added to my...
Wait, what does it say right... Down, up, go to the next page. Because you added your picture, changed some stuff. Names and locations are
all
there.
I know is Jackson and Johnny.
Huh. Yeah,
well, okay. Somebody was meant, I guess only he knows her. We didn't put any, we lost his, some of the changes, so we lost his contacts. Anyway, he knows Mariotti. The two Mafia people are connected.
Well, that makes
sense. Had a PC flag, so.
Yeah.
So,
we know each other.
Have you guys
we at least
need
one other person.
Have either of you guys called me yet?
Yeah. We're on the phone together to say, hey, we need to leave. We need to go get these people, but I think we should at least take one other person.
I just got off a ghost net with, what's his name here? What's your name again?
Brown Bird.
What is Mariotti?
Carter, does your character have any kind of ability to fly?
No! What is your character?
You're
a tossing dwarf, damn it.
You're a what? You're,
no,
you're a dwarf?
A cat?
Pilot?
What is your character, though? He's a dwarf what?
I'm a dwarven bounty hunter.
Do you know how to fly?
If I grab him by his
I can jump.
Spin around.
A little?
Do you know anyone who knows how to fly?
She means pilot, the skill pilot.
Yeah.
Do you have
just
say
one?
Why don't we just... Okay.
I got a truck!
Well, that's helpful. If we could get
we
down
need someone,
a bit.
We're going to fly down there.
I know.
For
why don't
oh,
we just fly on the commercial
Anthony, your character's on what I didn't have.
Get
add,
a Jeep.
Add 15 karma.
And drive.
And 50,000 New Year.
Hey, we're going to need a coyote.
Everybody's character
die.
Has,
no one's
has excess
die.
Karma to buy stuff as they need. So
died. Yeah.
If you need to buy a skill, just buy the skill.
That's what told me.
My little work, yeah, someone had an accident.
Yeah,
do you know any coyotes
15 karma and
down there?
52,755 million.
You
might have to
look
your character up.
Richard, do I have any coyotes in there? I figured that since I have some of the language skill, at some point in the past, I must have spent a little time there for some reason.
Yeah, I think that's fine.
Alright, so you have a coyote?
There's a guy that I knew back in the day. I don't know if I can even find him anymore. I mean, I haven't used him for years.
Well, put out
but,
a...
And of course, you guys can use fixers, or really anybody, any of your contacts.
I have a fixer.
Just some are
pretty...
You know, some are better than others.
I have Jackson. He's a 4-3. I don't know if that's loyal, but
yeah.
I have a corporate security contractor who's a 3-5.
I don't think any of you just... have a coyote contact because
no.
You just don't have a reason to hang out with someone who constantly crosses borders.
Except for the Mafia guy.
It's better to ask a Mafia contact for a coyote.
Yeah, I unfortunately don't see on the sheet where my contacts are.
Your contacts aren't there.
They
I'm,
just didn't get
we lost it somewhere along the way, yeah.
My Laura Falcon.
But just assume you have a 3 contact with... With some Mafia person.
Laura Falcon is only a 4-3, and she is...
Or a coyote, really, if you wanted.
No,
Ares
like
mission strategist.
And Ares obviously knows how to send special forces teams, which is exactly what you did all over the world.
Okay, so I know how to get us in now, and that's fine.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I know I can get that covered, but I think we're going to need some more... We might need some help tracking them down. Do you know any bounty hunters?
Yeah, I mean,
You're going in. Okay, so just some clarification. You're going, and Steve, like, you didn't really look up context because you know Mariotti.
Yeah, that's the only reason I asked.
If you answered, anyone else other than Mariotti.
Yes, I know. I know a perfect person for this role.
Yeah, that guy.
Yeah, my boss.
Yeah.
He says context don't fight with you. Anyway, three of you going to a nation where they rip people's hearts out if they catch you doing anything wrong is, you know, maybe...
Yeah, but four of us is better. No, but anyways, yeah, get your boss to go. I'll handle transport in and out. It's not going to be an issue. I don't think it'll be an issue for me, at least, right?
Depends on your roles.
Okay, so then my roles are going to be really good. Because I have to do that. I have to do that.
Okay, out of game.
Yep.
You put your hand on your head. It's out of game stuff. I'm going to tell them all that I don't think that Mariotti should come because he's going to want more share of the loot and stuff and rip us off, and I don't want to have to share with him. I'll still tell him we'll be out of town. But when I tell you we'll be out of town, you're like, you force out of me what's going on, and then you say you want to come. How about that? You're like, oh, I'm fucking coming too. We both
do. So you say what?
I don't necessarily want you to be there. I think it'd be a fun role play, but when I kind of tell you, you want more information about where exactly I'm going to be, and so I kind of let you in some, the details, and you're like, oh, I'm fucking coming on this shit. That sounds
it makes
like,
sense.
Big piles of
Wait. No, no, no. You're not, like, I'm coming along with you on this one. And so you basically butt in. So that happened. How about we say that?
No, yeah.
Do you want me to actually roleplay that one out?
Yes.
You got a little bit of time, so.
Okay.
I think it would be fun as well.
Okay, so I drop by. At this point, what are you doing? Are you already getting your club set up? Because he's the club owner, right? And the thing?
So right now, he's helping manage the club.
Okay, you manage the club. Okay, so I pop by the club. Hey, boss. I gotta be out of town for a few days. I got a thing. Might be lucrative.
God damn it, Tony, again? You piss off this time.
What do you mean again? This is like, I do this almost never. It's a good doc. A friend of mine, a guy I know from back in the day. He's in a little bit of trouble.
You punched a guy last Tuesday.
Yeah, you told me to punch him.
Then there was those five guys down the street, and... I'm not sure what happened to them. There was fire involved.
Yeah? Dude, that's what I do. You know what I do. What I'm here for. And I'm going to take a little bit of that down to Aslan. Because, you know, there's some trouble down there. I got to get a friend out of trouble. It's not a big. It's not a big thing. It's no big thing.
Sounds like a vacation you're going down south.
I'm going to have some fun when I'm down there. I'm not going to lie, you know.
You know that they're not gonna go for us. We gotta make it a work thing.
It is. I mean, it's kind of a work thing. It's business and pleasure.
Hey, but Tony, you need supervision.
What are you talking about?
We go down south, and those guys. You start setting them on fire and punching them. There's gonna be some stabbing going on your direction, and we don't want that because. I need you to cover shifts next week, and...
What are you saying?
Well, I'm saying I'm coming with you, make sure you don't screw this up.
You don't even know what I'm doing down there.
Whatever it is, you'll probably screw it up.
Look, can I talk to you out of this? You don't want to come down on this one. Trust me, boss. You don't.
Because then there was this last time, that last thing you screwed that up, and then there was that thing before that you screwed that up.
Well, you're always bringing that business up. So the water under the bridge.
Let's say you got practice screwing stuff up, so I'm going to come with you to make sure this don't get screwed up.
Or if you're going to come with, we're going to need, we need like a coyote. Because we're going to have to move some stuff out of the country. You're on the down low, they ain't do back.
I got a truck, we just took it in the back.
Well, don't you have a... Well, the whole reason we're contacting you is you had the access to the coyote.
He is a bounty hunter. We need a bounty hunter to find the coyote.
What?
Right?
Why?
We need to swallow the spider to catch the fly.
Exactly.
So wait, okay. I really quick. Why was we all need to get along, Anthony? I'm not sure what things you have that he had access to.
So I had. I think I am I the only one with a vehicle?
Maybe the only one with a big vehicle.
I don't know. My archetype.
But
was,
I don't know how you can get your big ass vehicle.
No, you both have the same vehicle?
I had a Toyota piece of crap or something.
You guys
both we both have the same vehicle. It's convoy.
Maybe it's the same. It's a mom vehicle. We use it back and forth as needed.
Really, I mean, really, he's just backup muscle.
A Toyota Gopher?
He does have a lot of stuff that might be good in the jungle. Just another survivor, right? He's got survival kits, and he's got... if you have to deal with Aztec guards, you probably don't want to kill them, or... You know, whatever he's got. Stun-batons, survival knives.
Are we thinking about taking a road trip and driving all the way down there?
I don't know what you guys are planning.
We take
it. But Ramsey is gonna, I mean, he's gonna...
So what do you think, Tony? Can we take the truck?
Look, we gotta be down there in about 5 to 6 days, preferably sooner. Yeah, if you wanna take the gopher and drive all the way to middle of Aslan, sure.
I don't know if we wanna put that kind of mileage on it.
Down for a road trip. Well, I mean, otherwise...
You got anybody with a plane?
We got the paperwork to, you know, cross the border and make it look like, you know, we're shipping goods or something. That might be a way to make it work.
I think the only way we're getting there is with a plane. Especially on that kind of timeline.
You can drive there in 5 days, easy. Where are we driving from? We're coming out of Seattle, I'm assuming?
Shit, we're not going to make it no 6 days.
Nah, driving shifts? Easy, 3 days.
Just take three. Still a lot of tears in the doorway. What the hell are you talking about, boy?
Like I'm going to trust you to drive.
We can be to like San Francisco.
You blew up the last 5 cars.
We could be to San Diego easy in 2 days. And that's no...
My insurance went up like triple. It was...
All right, fine. We got a perfectly good truck. We don't want to use it. Then all right, you tell me. You got contact. That's why I'm saying we need a coyote. Look, there's some... Look. I say this for business, for pleasure. The business part is going to need things to gotten out of the country on the down low. So, that's, if you're going to come along, that's what we need, boss.
Does it make sense that I could ask my Aries contact?
Are you going to ask Aries contact?
I mean, she's a mission strategist. Mm-hmm. So, I'm thinking to talk to her and say, you know, like, hey, I got some time off. You know, it's more to save a friend than anything else.
Yeah.
And, you know, some of the old stuff that we used to do, where I saved your ass back in blah, 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 mission blah, 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 classified X. Mm. And I'm gonna try to do a roll, basically, to see if I can convince her to, because, I mean, with a name like Falcon, she must either fly or do something strategic like that, where she can authorize...
You know that she can fly. She normally arranges transport.
So I'm gonna try to talk to her about arranging transport for us in and out.
Okay.
I'm gonna say that my fixer contact on here is a mob fixer, right? I'm going to call him Mario Nine Toes.
Do I just need to do a dice roll?
Yep.
Loyalty or connection?
Actually, I like Joey Nine Toes better.
It's connection.
Both of them multiplied by 6? Excellent.
What is the die roll against your contact?
Hey, boss, there's 4. A couple other my friends, you know, guys that I ran with.
Oh, no, connection is what they do. It's loyalty is what you roll.
They come along on this too already. They ain't just doing me.
Well, that's
good.
You
want to spend edge on it?
You know there's that parole officer.
I don't get to add anything to it.
Definitely get that out of town. It's kind of secret. Like,
wait, who's got a parole officer?
My character actually has a parole officer as a contact.
Oh yeah. You know I've never been on the inside. I've been careful like that.
You got a plane?
Except for that one time. Do I have a plane? And we could call Joey Nine Toes. I'm just using my picture so you might know.
Doesn't he owe you something? Did you break his face once, or what?
Nah, you know, he's a good boy. Here's the deal, though, you know, if he helps us out on the plane, he's gonna want, you know, something in return. I can give him a call.
Yeah, do that.
Alright, I'm gonna call my fixer. Then, who's now my fixer?
Where's my dice rolling thing?
Well, wait, hold on. You know what? Who knows how to fly a plane? We need a pilot too? I don't want to bring any more people in on this.
What do I look like, a canary?
I might have to partner. Hold on.
You're small.
I'm gonna see what's going on here. Why am I? What happened to my? Oh, S. There it is. There's dozen guys. Okay, Lucas right. Films.
I seriously have no.
So.
For people.
I don't know. If other people wanted to drive, fly in and list, I'd rather just take the truck and drive.
Okay.
So you're going to make a negotiation test.
23. Oh, negotiation?
Yep. It's flat negotiation plus your contact's loyalty.
So 2 plus 3. And roll. 2 successes. Five or better, right? If it's 4 or better, I have 4 successes.
Okay, so that's not very good because she got 1 more than you. Now, what are you specifically asking for?
I'm asking her to give me help to get into the, like, sneak into the country, and then sneak us back out.
How many?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 5 in, 6 out. No, 4 in, 5 out. Well, I don't know, maybe we meet someone we like there if we want to bring him back.
What kind of
timeline? He's doing the Aries math, don't worry about it.
And what?
What kind of timeline?
We want a quick in and quick out. We probably need at most a day in there. I mean, does that make sense, guys? Or should this take longer than a day for us to... Like, all we're doing is digging him out literally and leaving, right?
That's what we think.
And yeah. Smuggling crap out of here.
Getting things out. We don't know how close.
Assuming nothing goes wrong.
Yeah, okay, yeah. So it's not just us, it's also we're going to smuggle out some shit.
Just keep him out is probably the easier part of it.
God, this is. Whoa.
What?
This dice are on the program. Mm. This shooting dice.
As well, I can't. With what little you've told me, I can't risk moving around any Ares resources, and it would be a little suspicious if both of us were, you know, out of the city at the same time for a non-licensed Ares mission. But what I can do is I can arrange to put you on a series of trains that takes you into the capital, and it will take you, and she like starts doing stuff on her computer. She says, I think it will take you about a day and a half.
To get there?
Yeah.
And then how long to get back?
In the semi world, your trains run more efficiently because that's really fast.
Yeah, it is really fast.
So it would take 48 hours to drive there. Just using our, like normal cars, using our roads.
Sounds about right.
Yeah. Obviously, they have hyper trains. You can go to LA from Seattle in Shadowrun
within a couple hours. Like, I mean, it's...
Yeah, why don't we do that? We take, like, a normal train to L.A.
No, she's saying that she's...
California.
This is, she, I mean, you're not taking a special train.
Oh.
All she's saying is that she can set up the trains and she can give you the paperwork to the visas to...
Oh, she can get all the way through that. Okay, well, then that might actually be worth it. Because I was thinking, I mean...
Okay, let's get in there. I'll get in there.
Yeah, would that get us back also?
You'd have to... Says she can arrange it back out, but her, you know, the visas she gives you aren't going to be as good on the way out because they're going to be, I mean, these are digital visas, and they're just, so they're just not probably giving you good, but she can give you another series of visas for the way out. But basically, it's going to cost you the same amount to go out as it is in.
How much is it going to cost?
She's saying, let me just check something real quick to make sure this isn't ridiculous.
It is already.
It probably is already, yeah.
I rolled 3 successes this time.
So she's saying she can get you the visas, and these are going to be rank 3 visas, with the transportation for 15,000 yuan each.
In and out?
No.
That's one way.
That's one way.
Fuck my
God. That's per person.
The question is how we get stuff out.
Yeah. Is there any way to negotiate that price down?
She's like, no, because she's not even making anything off this deal. She's doing it as a favor.
Okay. Let me talk to the rest of them.
She's like, okay. Yeah, if you have any other information or anything that would give me leeway to just buy anything, just let me know. Or this deal, you know, it will be good for the next 6 hours.
Thanks. Crap. I mean, I can't think of anything that would make this something that Ares would justify.
So, fake sins cost 7,500 credits a piece. Mm-hmm. So, visas that would get you past 4 international borders is probably not a bad deal.
No, it sounds like...
Not using visas at all and sneaking past 4 borders, obviously, would be cheap. Or cheaper, or free. Mm-hmm. Depending on whether you had to pay somebody to help you sneak past those borders. But what she's basically giving you is a hopefully legitimate, hopefully the guards scan your things and there's not a problem kind of deal.
Mm-hmm.
Other coyotes might not have you scan at all and just try to bypass it. They could go by boat. But I think boat's going to be longer. I don't know. And obviously by air. Air is going to be the most expensive, but the most foolproof way in and out. And that's how he got it. That's how Jason's character got it in and out. Black Feather.
Yeah, but how much air does air cost?
A ridiculous amount.
Hmm.
Well, actually, but maybe not.
I mean this time you'd think it'd be cheaper.
It might not cost, because it's so many of you. So it might be cheaper.
Hmm.
And you have a plane sitting there.
I know, I was already thinking of getting back using the plane, but the only thing is none of us can pilot.
And spend karma.
I can spend karma on it, I guess.
Whoever has the best stats for it.
Is it reaction or agility? It's agility, right?
That's reaction for piloting.
It's what?
Reaction for piloting.
And Anthony's character is already quite
spend,
the pilot.
I only need to spend 1 point in piloting aircraft, and then I'll have an 8. It's not bad.
It's not bad. I think 10 is, like, pretty average, right? So, none of your characters have skill softs, right?
What's that?
That's implanted skills.
No.
Because otherwise, then it's just money, right? You just buy the skill. You download it.
Yeah, I just
have my character in the other game does.
Security extreme sport.
I need to start using that. What?
Rank one, right?
Oh yeah, so only using it to one rank in it.
But then it's just like
then it's
you literally just download it off the net whenever you.
Yeah, I need to rank like 10. That'd be awesome. Okay, well, thank you. I'll keep that in mind. I get on the comm link with everyone. Hey, we all need to meet. I need to talk to you about. I have a way in, but it's expensive.
Cool.
So we all meet up, I'm assuming.
So what kind of funds do you guys have?
We all have the same, 550.
Not everybody has the same. Some people have more karma, and some people have more yin. All right,
well, I have 50 money. So I can't pronounce that word. That word does not even make sense.
No idea how much karma I have, but I have 4,800 yuan.
I have like 5 yuan.
You have 15 karma, Steve.
Okay. Once after the Jupus. Right away, that's right.
Yeah, so I have a character open.
Okay. I have 2 karma.
Okay, well, so here's the deal. 15,000 both way, each way, so it'd be 30,000 a piece, plus 4 black feather. And that would almost guarantee us to get in. Or we can try through a fixer that maybe one of them knows. One of our fixers might know a smuggler or something. Do you have a fixer?
Yeah.
I have a fixer.
Joey Mentos. He's a mob guy.
Can you help us get in cheaper than that?
I don't know. Can you give him a call?
Please.
Isn't a corporate security contractor be able to get us somewhere too?
Good.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so I call. My good buddy Joey. Nine toes. Hey Joey. Looking to
you
get.
You don't have mine open, do you?
Looking to get into Aslan.
And
smuggle some shit out.
Oh, I don't have yours open.
You've got the means to make that happen?
I just realized something. Couldn't I tell her, couldn't I have us go down to train people in the Ares Corps military base there? The one that's closest to Tenochtitlan.
So
fly directly there.
Ares does not. So as technology
the name of your character again?
And the nation of Aslan,
Mariotti,
almost the same thing, and they don't allow other corporations to operate in their country. Yeah. Definitely, they don't allow military. They probably allow non-military things to operate. And they kind of enslave their people and stuff. I mean, they're like pretty evil and stuff. However, you could try to go to the Confederated American States, like New Orleans.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty close. Then you just take a boat over there.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, I mean, you can try to change this to get her to approve an Ares thing.
That's what I'm thinking, is maybe approve something for me to go there with these people, go get my friend, come back. On the way back, when I get there, then stay down there and do either, if Ares has something for me to do and as it long for them, at the same time do that, then come out, or do some training down there of their troops.
The shipping seems like not a bad idea. We could go out of Los Angeles and come in on the other side of the coast.
Yep.
Truck it west and then
yeah,
go.
Yeah, but what
up.
Nation is up there?
What
What's
nation?
In LA? Yeah.
What's LA is
LA
the California
is
Free State.
Yeah. San Diego, though, is part of Aslan.
So they're not part of the UCAS?
We might find a ship coming right out of Seattle.
Yeah. Okay, so I think you're talking to Jimmy Nantosa.
Yeah. So, Jimmy, looking to get some stuff out of Aslan. And Mariotti wanted to come along with us, too. And I got 2 other guys. What?
What if I wanted to come along?
Oh, good Lord, Jimmy. You know this. I mean, you know, he's Jimmy now. Does anyone else have a contact named Jimmy?
No.
No, I have Johnny.
Jimmy.
Johnny and Jackson.
Jimmy, this ain't your thing. This is might be dangerous. You know you're just doing putting the shit together so guys like me can do the hurting.
Alright. Well, what about my cut, though? Because I'm helping.
Yeah. I told him that you need a cut. Just look, tell me if you can make it, and then I'll, how much it's going to cost. I'm going to take care of you. Look, you're
I'm just
town.
Ribbing you. What do you need?
I'm thinking easiest way, if you know of any ships, find this ship or whatever, we can get on it. Could be a container ship, probably the easiest, heading down that way. Put us on this crew or something like that. You're the one that makes it happen. Get the boat going down to Aslan. We get off the ship. We get into Tenochtitlan. I don't know how to say it. Pretend my character said it right. I should know how to.
Pretend your character didn't say it right.
He probably should, though.
That's probably true. He can't speak the language.
Yeah.
I just say, actually, it'd be funny if nobody can say it right. Even if they...
I can say I'm looking at...
I can't say it right like that, me neither.
Tenochtitlan, guys. Tenochtitlan.
You should have one more syllable.
Tenochtitlan.
Yeah, but we don't say that.
But nobody knows how to say it right. And everyone's like, oh yeah, that place that nobody knows how to say
okay,
it.
Okay, pretty much right near Tenochtitlan, but outside the main city in the jungle, there's a guy that's in trouble. Alright, we need to get him out. You don't need to know too many of the details, right? Do you want to know the details? Here's details.
I don't need no details.
One moment.
You see his eyes start flickering over some, you know, AR screen that you can't see. And he's, so it's kind of moving his fingers, and in a moment...
Like, I tell him what he knows, and I like, a guy needs to get out, so we have to get 4 in, 5 out. And we need to be able to smuggle some shit out, which they don't want us to take out, because that's how we all get paid. There.
Alright. Negotiate plus 3 dice.
Negotiate plus 3 dice. Just get some of these dice, makes any sense.
Yeah.
Negotiation. He's not very good at negotiating.
Roll.
Oh, no, he actually has decent negotiation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's why he rolls some out of his
He always has his white ones now.
Fives
Yeah.
Ones are crit and fails?
Yep.
Yeah. Alright, oh, 2 ones and 1 5.
I'm straight from the container.
Can I, how much?
So it's a glitch if you roll half your dice in ones, and it's a critical glitch if you roll no successes or if you just fail. How does that work?
How much edge does he have? Only 1 edge?
No successes.
And then it'd be critical, but he got 1 success. He didn't roll half, so it's a success. Mm-hmm. He got 1.
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I've got a couple things going on, but a lot of them. Yeah, I don't really want to, it doesn't matter, those things. Oh, so I've got the one. So we've got a ship we're supposed to protect. It's actually an Aztec ship, but it doesn't have any Aztec employees on. And, there's quite a few people that are going to go out past the border. And they've already paid to have the ship not be inspected. And, well, there might be some other people on the ship from China. So we could sneak you in the boxes, but you'd have to kind of, not pay so much attention to the women and children.
What are you telling me?
So you could sneak on, and we'll help you sneak on, but then you got to get off before you get into the... into the harbor at Tenochtitlan, because, once the Aztechnology people get a hold of that ship, they're not going to like you guys so much.
Alright, how are we supposed to do that?
Jump ship when you get in the river. Tenochtitlan is land bound, but actually it has rivers running through it, so the way it works is the ships, we just run the ships along the coast, try to stay out of the storms, out of the spirit, mana storm things, whatever the madness is, and we go right up the river, and then we offload, they put stuff back on, and then they come back.
Okay, so that's getting us down there?
That's getting us down there.
And how are we getting back out?
Well,
same ship coming back the same way?
I could let you know the schedules of the ships, and whenever you're ready, you could, you know, sneak back on in the river after it's left their harbor. But it is jungle, and I wouldn't want to be, you know, hanging out with those weird mutant crocodile things.
Yeah, here's the deal. They can arrange it so we ain't jumping off and swimming, but they, you know, they lower a dinghy or something and we can go off. We'll bring the fire.
Remember when he kind of wanders by, you're like, what, are you afraid of a little water? And he's like, like survival knife. And
yeah. We're making some guns and stuff, so, they can lower a boat, right?
I only imagine that your character makes every mission, and he's like, you know, I'm going to need some extra guns.
Yeah.
And they just keep giving it to him. So now they're going to take, like,
they can lower a boat or something and bring us back up. That seems no problem.
Well, we could let you bring a boat, and then you could just take it.
Yeah, all right, little dinghy type of inflatable thing. Yes. As long as they have a way to lift this up, we can just leave the stupid boat. How much the boat cost? 10,000? 10,000?
I don't know about the boat. I never had to buy a boat. But I'm sure I can ask around and.
I don't do shipping.
Fancy boat? Normal boat? Raft?
Yeah, like those inflatable type ones with a lot more motor, you know? Like special forces guys use, you know?
Well, what kind of treasure are we going to get out, though?
That might be perfectly the kind of thing that Sarge can acquire.
Yeah.
Maybe for free, just like borrow one of their. Like stealth rafts.
I don't know, a little six-man raft like that. I could probably cull a few crates worth of stuff.
Those things are actually pretty dang good.
Mm.
Yeah.
With a big-ass orc in it, though? Think about it.
Maybe they're resized for orcs. I mean,
those boats are.
If you were going to hire shock troopers in the Shadowrun world, I don't think they'd be tiny.
They're eight-man boats. Right? The special forces boats?
I know, they probably make six-man ones too. They probably have even bigger ones in. Well, I don't know. Anyway, Sarge can work that out. Actually, I like that shipping thing. How much is this gonna, alright, talk to me. How much is this gonna cost to make all this happen? And your cut too. Just lay it on me.
Well, let's just make it 10%.
Oh boy.
So this is an investment.
I'm already packing, and as he's talking, and so I'm like handing, like stacking stuff on Joey or Jimmy.
Do we have
just to have him hold it?
Jason, do I have any way of getting a hold of you, or do I have to wait for your ghosts to pop up?
You have to wait, because I'm.
It's up to you if you want to hang around for hours at a time waiting for them to make their plans.
I
assume you probably have a vested interest in their.
I would check in the next day, I suppose.
Hey, we're already boss.
She's gorgeous.
Of course, I gotta find him first. That's the trick.
Good height, honor, everything.
Jimmy Nintos wants 10% of all of this to make it happen.
We're on a time schedule, right?
Yeah, we're on a time schedule. I mean, that seems like a lot. He's taking us to the cleaners on this.
You didn't ask him how long he is.
What's it?
You didn't ask him how long.
Well, keep in mind, he doesn't know what 10% of what is.
Okay, how long is it going to take?
3 days.
Huh?
3 days before the ship leaves?
No. It's leaving the day. It'll take 3 days to get there.
That sounds great. That's a very convenient. Problem is ships leaving right away. We need to kind of be chop on this.
Should have the money together to get that going.
But, I don't know.
On all
Anthony, do you have like better negotiate skills or something? Can you try to renegotiate? I mean,
I don't have negotiate.
Oh, you might have any negotiate?
Oh,
terrible.
She's not doing anything.
I don't think I could do any better.
I'm more stuck in intimidate.
You're kind of probably higher up than him. You want to come up and intimidate him and take off? I don't know. What do you think? You think it's worth it? I mean,
I have to go through and exit that piece.
We'll probably still come out ahead. I just think we're taking his, he's busting my balls here.
I'm gonna roll up to Jimmy with the. So I've got my shotgun, just because I have a shotgun.
Yeah.
Because I've got a shotgun. And I'm just gonna kind of set it on his shoulder and be like, Jimmy, we're really on a time crunch here. We gotta be moving fast. I know we could pay you a little bit more, but we gotta.
Well, the time isn't the problem. The thing is just how much money he wants. Time already works, right?
Yeah, shut up, Tony. The grown-ups are talking.
Like, well, I guess make a roll.
So basically, I'm trying to, obviously the gun is intimidating, but I'm trying to make it sound not really. So let's see here.
Oh, then I'll take my set.
Three successes.
He got three successes as well.
That's the problem with it.
Look, what's the problem here? You don't even know how much you're gonna find.
And that's why.
Well, neither do you. 20% could be great, could be not so great.
Wait, he asked for 10%.
Yeah, he was 2%.
If you want to go up to 20%, he's totally on board for that.
Well, your negotiation really is bad.
yeah, I'm saying...
Look,
I want
30%, that's my final offer.
Wait, are you negotiating with him, or are you negotiating with the hammer?
So I'm saying, I'm trying to make it sound like we'll pay him more if he goes faster, but also there's a shotgun next to his head.
Faster isn't the problem. What part of that are you missing? Is the only issue is how much money you want.
So out of character, I think with 3 days we'd be cutting it really, really close with him having 5 days.
Yeah.
5 days is how much food he has. He can go.
It's true. He'll start taking stun damage and just be weaker at spells after that.
And then, let's assume that we're not the best people at digging anything out.
Yeah, I don't know if we're all that strong.
Look, main thing here is getting the loot. Saving Jason is just a side perk.
It's really
let's get a priority straight.
Six.
If
I do two.
Reaction of four.
Look, if you pay 30,000 up front, then I can have the captain go a bit faster. It's going to cost more fuel. And he's going to have to bypass some stops that maybe he was hoping to get a little extra on his side. So... and then at the same time, I can go down to 9%. And it'll probably take 2 days. You guys aren't rolling great here, so I'm not going to get you a big deal. I'm just willing to move the numbers around.
Whatever you want to do, I mean, we can wait to see if Jason wants your Black Heather. Ghosts in again and be like, hey, is it worth 30,000 for you to not, fast? Is a sandwich worth 30,000 friggin' yen for you? If I was in that situation, I would just, I don't know, drink my piss or something.
Jason also has a grandfather that he has high loyalty with. And he has money, and Anna has her probably one contact.
I have two contacts.
Two contacts.
I have a fixer.
So you can only get a third option. Right now you have a flat cash option that's pretty fast.
What's it called?
And you have a cheaper option that takes longer.
Let's keep Jimmy on the line for 10%, if he wants to do that, then we'll get
nine.
Back to him.
Stop talking it up. He's willing to take nine. Nine plus extra 30,000 if we want to bribe the captain into fucking
What did we bribe the captain for? I thought we were taking our little...
I thought the construct was 30,000, and then he lowers to 9 because of the 30,000.
That means he's a little weak. If you don't want to pay the captain to go faster, then you could probably fight for that 9%.
How long would this take?
3 days. Or it'll take...
But 2 days for natural 3,000, we can have him... Make this shit go faster.
3 days is fine.
Skip some stuffs and...
Yeah.
Okay. Sure.
Is that what you
it might be worth it to give us some buffer in case, you know, I don't know, we have a hard time finding them.
Do we
want
to go with a third person? I mean, I have a fixer that is a loyalty of 3 to me.
Well, you're doing your own thing, Anna, so nobody can stop you from just making the roll and making the call. So.
Check with them, but I like the ship. It seems really good. It's all, they are already smuggling. Please. They're already smuggling
so
people out.
So you're negotiation to your loyalty.
To my loyalty?
Mm-hmm.
So should I go with the fixer or the contractor?
I mean, yeah, obviously the contractor's better. The only problem is what does the contractor do?
Yeah.
I have no idea. What does the contractor do?
Corporate security contractor. What does that
so
do?
Possibly he could get us, like he could probably get us fake IDs to get down there, and then we could just use regular speed train to get us all the way there. Instantly,
okay.
Like within 3 hours. So
that's if your contact can get us solid credentials, you can combine that with the train, become there faster and cheap.
But getting the loot out, they don't like anything taken out of the country. How are we
going to
get
this guy on the way
effects?
In and your guy on the way out?
Yeah.
We might be able to make that work.
But
or we take
see.
The plane because I'll spend one effing point and have 8 flight. 3 is average, by the way.
After she's done calling her a thing, I'll call back.
3, but you're gonna have 1.
I'm gonna have 8.
They don't count by dice, they count by rating. 3 is average rating.
What does it cost, how many karma to raise a skill? From 0 to 1, I think it's only 1, right? And then it's like 3 to get to the second one or something like that. And then like 5, I think, to the second, next one.
I always use the software, so I don't know.
The only reason I like picking shit down is because we know exactly where
successes.
We're gonna get dropped off and be picked up.
For
I want to talk to Johnny Big Rig. He is a corporate security contractor, and all I have to do is usually text him, and he helps me out. He has a connection of 3 and a loyalty of 5.
She's asking basically to get us IDs that would get us through all the countries straight to Tenochtitlan, basically like a business passport or something. That would get us all the way there instantly, you know, on a speed train. You rolled all 1s. Critical failure.
I rolled 1 success, by the way.
Woohoo! So I have 5 successes to your 1. That means I really am good at this negotiation bullshit. Woo!
That means he really likes you.
Because
he
loves
you.
He
likes you.
Maybe he's my boyfriend, that's why he has a loyalty of 5.
That's right.
He says.
You went down 1.
That made her hair blush.
Oh. Wow. do you have a color hair?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
She can change the color of her hair to blend better. That's part of her spy.
Okay.
Cool.
So he says that he's got a job in Tenochtitlan that he needs done within the next 2 weeks.
Okay.
Perfect. We'll do them both. We'll get our guy, then do the job, then get home.
Alright. What do we have to do for this job? Or what do I have to do for the job?
So, you would have to meet with the Johnson, who is from Evo Corporation. He's Russian. He,
Evil Corporation.
He's Mexican Russian?
He's a black Irish.
From Aslan's perspective, he's just a traitor. He's not connected with Evo. They will get you in. They'll fly you in.
Okay.
You would be there in 14 hours or so. If you're successful, they will pay you and get you out of there.
Alright.
If you're not successful, then...
find your own ride back.
Find your own ride back. And you'd be on the ticket for the price to get down there.
Okay.
I like that plan much better.
Make sure that getting out includes getting our shit out that we need to
sort out. We are all going to meet the Johnson. We haven't met the Johnson yet.
So he, but this person knows that it's four going down, five coming back with shit.
No, the fixture doesn't know any of that yet.
Well, he has to know that. That has to be part of this conversation.
Four people, and then when we're down there, we have a fifth person.
Or we
bring
my ship coming down and just have them pay us money, like we'll work, we'll get out on our own and get more money. We can try that for them.
No, this is
fine. I'm okay with going down there and if they're gonna pay for both ways.
Yeah,
it's that's a great. safer bet.
I just want to make sure stuff can get out because that's how we get money.
Well, we have to talk to the Johnsons and
so
see what
we're also gonna make money on this mission.
Because if their plan is like, I'm taking you out, I'm not getting out crates of artifacts.
Yeah. Was she able to check if they can break all of us?
To them, okay? We haven't talked to the Johnsons yet.
No, the Johnsons in Aslan.
Oh, they're in
Aslan. So he's gonna broker you going down there right now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So, all right, then I have to have that conversation. So we have four people going down.
Okay.
And my team is four, but on our way back, we'll have five. So really, it's four down,
stuff.
Five up.
Plus
so
five for the mission.
Hold on.
Right.
We potentially could four down, four out, and once we get Jason out, we just put him on the boat with his shit, and he takes it back.
No, why don't we say four in, five back with stuff.
With stuff.
And so, five is going to be the mission.
So we're going to have five people at the end for the actual mission while we're down there, but we'll have four going down.
I think their response is going to be why.
He says, I'll get back to you. Half an hour later, he video messages you back.
Okay.
And he says, Laura, Evo is very interested. I went ahead and forwarded them over some of your past successes.
Excellent.
And they think you're the right team for the job. They will pay 35,000 new yen apiece. They'll fly all of you plus 200 pounds of gear each. You'll negotiate the actual job down there. If you turn it down, they would charge you 80,000 one way just to get there.
Okay.
For wasting their time.
But for everyone.
Yeah.
Just one cost.
But that's not to get out.
I know.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure that it's like, if they say like, hey, murder the head of Aslan or whatever, and we don't fucking say, okay.
They think you'll be successful. They want the job completed. That's what they tell you.
Alright.
Yeah, 35K a piece, and they get us out?
You guys don't know yet.
You know, if it's
and
murder
they get us back,
village,
right?
Then,
you guys
and they'll get you back out.
Alright.
Plus
so.
That other guy. Plus the
but
the
you
weight.
Have to get it completed within 14 days.
14 days.
Yeah, how long does it take to get there if they're flying us in?
14 hours.
14 hours.
Okay.
How's a 14-hour flight?
You're going to be there in 14 hours.
Got it.
You're
can
leaving
I
in
this, or are we
hours.
Just going to
yeah.
just
yeah.
Like, play it? Cause
you know, Raz can't help it.
I know, we can't help it.
Yeah,
I can't.
Alright, so I text you all to meet at a local coffee shop that's kind of off the beaten path that I've already bug checked and know that...
There's a coffee shop every block.
So Starbucks.
Yes.
It's Seattle. There are all of the coffee shops.
We are going to the Seattle coffee shop on the corner of 4th and Main.
Oh, that's the corporate headquarters for Starbucks on this block.
Meet me here in half an hour or don't bother. That's what I say.
Copy.
She's kind of bitchy.
Well, you know, she is a spy and she was fucking good at it.
Coffee leaf and tea bean.
That's where Steve's character goes.
Because he's stupid. I said Seattle coffee on 4th and Main. Alright, so I'm assuming y'all make it. Of course, the mafia guys really hate it when I give ultimatums. Alright, so this is what my guy says. Okay? He says that there is a job to do down in the place. I don't know how to pronounce it.
Don't worry, we can't say it either.
Okay. In the T-word.
Hey, Jason, feel free to say that you're there as well, because...
Because you're astral.
Yeah.
But yes, of course.
So anyway, so maybe you're just following me around. I don't know. So there's Johnson down there who wants us to do a thing. We don't know what the thing is. We have to wait till we get down there. But if we're, but no matter what, they'll fly all four of us down there. It'll only take about 14 hours to get down there. And if we're successful, they'll pay for us. They'll pay extra on top of flying us back in.
How much do they pay us?
$3,500 or $35,000?
Yes. $35,000
a piece?
Yeah. Holy hell!
$35,000 a piece, and they'll fly us back here with including 200 pounds, and that includes Mr. 200
pounds each? Or
200
pounds
each? Each person. So that includes Black Feather. However, if we're not successful, okay, we have 14 days to be successful on their mission. If we're not successful, it's going to cost us $80,000 and we won't have a way out.
Well, why don't we take this deal, set up the whole thing with the boat as a plan B to get us out.
How much is the boat going to cost us, though?
Nothing. He just wants a percentage, right?
Well, so that costs us something, because I guess if we use the boat or not, he's still probably going to want a percentage.
Yeah, but it's just a percentage of whatever we get from the stash at Blackfeather's place. Which, hey, have you checked out the other room yet to see what's in there? Or have you even told us about that? No, you said there's treasure there. Yeah, so how much treasure is there?
Jason?
Blackfeather?
How much? I don't know. That's rich.
Okay, so Jason, you can see, I would say probably $40,000 or $50,000 worth of gold, just in like terms of raw material value.
Okay.
But you guys are on both screens, so I keep wanting to look there.
Yeah.
But you actually can't spend too much time astrally outside of your little cave, because there's astrally aware creatures or critters.
Oh, yeah.
in the temple, and you think, you're not sure, but you think there might be a feathered serpent, which is a draco form, and you don't know what it's doing. You just think you saw it, and it may or may not have interest in the treasure or you or whatever, because draco forms are essentially higher beings. And so far, you've just avoided it, right? Like, it doesn't seem to be interested in you, but you haven't gone near the treasure because that's where there seems to be a lot of creatures and spirits that seem to be attracted by the powerful item.
Gotcha. Okay.
You did not have any problem killing the, I guess, the critters that were there so far.
But okay, so there's... I forgot already. A significant amount of gold.
Okay.
That's heavy. You gotta get it out. And there are some parrot critters in the neighborhood.
And obviously, if you ignore the raw material value, if you use contacts to sell the artifacts, they could be worth significantly more.
Oh yeah.
I mean, they could be worth hundreds of thousands if you find the right buyers for them.
Okay.
But you don't know that. I mean, it's...
Sounds like you'll be selling it to my character.
Well, for 35K, that's got to be some job they have in mind. Mm-hmm.
But they really think that we'll be successful, so.
Well, okay.
You guys are funny. Tony, where'd you pick these guys up?
What?
I said, where did you pick these guys up?
What guys? These guys?
Next thing you know, he is like Chris.
These guys.
I don't know. I know these guys.
My chick balances over her table and lands right behind you with her knife to your throat when you say that. Don't fuck with us. And then she bounces back.
So what's your intimidate score?
I don't have an intimidate score.
Okay. So I already have my gun pointed right back at you.
Uh-huh.
Right, my sister, I've killed prettier and smarter than you.
that's
maybe
awesome.
Smarter.
with no intimidation, she just kind of, it came off as a very impressive move. But
that is what she wanted to showcase, is her impressive flexibility. Super flexible. All
right. So
I'm busy being a dwarf to clap priorities.
So are you going to try to arrange the boat ride back?
No, I don't want to give him. Here's the deal.
Because you could offer less, right? He's not getting you in anymore. It could be a negotiating tactic.
If
she has a lame excuse for
But also you might
Do I have a way to call him from down there? I mean, I can still call him from down there, right?
You could buy a satellite uplink before you leave.
Okay, then.
Because you probably don't want to use the Aslan matrix.
I think that's a good idea. So yeah. Satellite uplink. If we need to, I can get a hold of Nine Toes, and we can probably connect with the ship on the way out, if
Nine
need be.
Toes?
As long as we figure, we know it's going down in about 3 days. I don't know how long it's going to be in port. I could ask him, but say 5 days, it's coming back.
He tells you, actually, these things happen fairly regularly. The ships come in from China.
Right, okay.
And then they go down to Aslan, because Aslan constantly needs more. Well, they want more shipments from other poor countries. And, they always need more people.
Yeah.
These boats are going to just keep coming.
So, buy a satellite uplink, and if we need it, we can call it and negotiate it with them then and make it happen. And he'll want to cut. And I'm assuming it'll be about half of what it was before, so 5% or maybe 6%, I don't know.
Sounds good to me. Worst comes to worst, we get down there and the job sounds like hell,
cool.
Or whatever, bye.
So,
I'm sure if we have to, we can get a little boat or canoe or something to get, so we don't have to stay.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure
canoe.
That we had.
Awesome.
Money can be put in people's hands.
Alright, so, I'm going to plan next Friday's game with the assumption that you guys are going to go on a some sort of air transport from Evo, and
we're going to get down there, try and rescue him, then get the job, and do the job.
Yep.
Cool. I like it.
Cool beans. So that was the intro, and sorry everyone had to make the characters. I wanted to have it all done, but...
Mm. Mm. It worked out well. It's
nice
short, bite-sized intro.
I was forced to be slightly more familiar with Chummer, even though I obviously am not familiar with how to save.
I don't blame you. I think it was probably my fault for opening the character first, like opening it too fast before it had time to sync. And then it automatically synced back. So that's why it was unfortunate. I've used Chummer to build so many characters now that obviously I'm pretty decent.
Yeah, you're dead.
Yeah.
Yeah, forced to search through, at least for
Did you ever press play on that?
Skills and, I mean not skills,
I don't know.
Equipment.
It's coming up.
A little late. Pretty much after work, I went home straight away and took a nap. Because otherwise, if I didn't right now, I would have been already passed out on the low sack. Yeah.
No worries. I thought we had some good chattering about movies and stuff. So.
Yeah. And even if it's just filling out, you know, archetypes and stuff, character creation is always kind of one of my favorites.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I would like to, I'm going to probably go through Chummer, and there's so many things to learn just looking at the basic Shadowrun character. I mean, even though I know I could never afford to build this character, even though he's weaker than me, which is kind of weird, but his equipment's better. So it's like, there's give and take there, you know what I mean?
There is, so did you guys take a look at those threads that I posted in the Shadowrun forum, or the Shadowrun channel on Slack?
Maybe I do not, I don't think so. Why?
So some of the threads were like, here is a kit worth of gear that you probably want to have that will cover a lot of situations. I've got stuff like glow sticks, zip ties, flashlights.
So an adventurer's kit.
Yeah, it's a essentially a Shadowrun adventurer's kit.
Hmm.
You know, RFID tags. Some of them have rope.
I always get confused about RFID tags in Shadowrun because I know what RFID tags are in real life.
Yeah, me
yeah.
too.
And here they're little multi-purpose spy tools.
Oh!
Yeah.
They can see things, they can hear things, you just kind of like put them places and...
Oh, I had no idea. Every time you guys say that, I think like, what, am I going to tag something?
So,
maybe we can...
You have a whole sweep for bugs thing?
Short-term...
So there's a tag eraser that you can actually buy, which is exactly for that purpose. You basically just sit there and run it over, because almost... Hey, it says in the book, your pants have ARFIDs in them. So if you want to sufficiently unbug a place, you have to literally just kind of go over it with a tag eraser to make sure it is unbugged.
Yeah.
Mm. So go to the hotel room, and the pillow has some tags in it to make sure it is the right sleeping frequency or sleeping firmness for you.
That's why I think it'd be very difficult to murder anything. Really anything anonymously. Like, there is going to be some sort of digital tracking of anything you do. And you just have to hope that nobody cares.
You just go in naked.
and
for you,
that
doesn't work.
They had a whole paragraph on the tag eraser and exactly why you have that.
Yeah, but my cyberware is not RFID.
Yes, it is.
It is.
I'll undo it.
So on your stuff, yes, you can turn off your own things. But, you know, say if you do want to go murder hobo and a bunch of guys, well, yeah, after you do that, you kind of have to fry all of their ARFIDs so that they can't transmit anything.
It's like everything is monitoring all the time.
That's why you need a good hacker. A good
but
hacker.
You don't have one, and one, you guys didn't just, like, rely on, like, the magic decker, like, giving you guys fake whatevers or all kinds of stuff. And number two, you're gonna be in some old Mayan temple.
Yeah,
and so the hacker would have felt kind of crappy. Now on the job that I didn't know Anna was gonna roll high enough to like suddenly
I know,
get.
That's
suddenly
the
decker
about.
Would have been really useful. I don't know, maybe you'll have to hire a Aslani Chatterer or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
We'll see.
We may have
to. Or just do it the hard way.
Or just do it the hard way, yeah.
Do you remember the champ diary? Muhammad Ali?
What? What?
Did Muhammad Ali pass away?
And somebody dies every day.
Jesus.
It's like there's seven billion people in the...
Actually, I guess the intimidation would have been seven. Seven dice.
Okay.
What's your intimidation?
Why? Eight.
Oh, because it's intimidation plus charisma.
He's a dwarf.
Yeah,
but
he doesn't care.
It doesn't matter. It all depends on how
dwarves are like honey badgers, so.
Like honey badgers.
It's against your charisma plus willpower, though. How do you have eight? Do you have eight with charisma plus willpower?
If you're intimidating me, I can intimidate you right back.
Man, he's
okay, is that all right?
So
yeah,
I can resist your intimidate with charisma plus willpower, and then just intimidate you right back.
So then we would just be an odd.
And you brought a knife to a gunfight, apparently. So.
Yeah. I have several knives. But what you
so the fun thing about that is if I'm pointing a gun.
Slapped it.
The thing is with the social rules. If you do bring a knife to a gunfight, you are at a penalty and I get a bonus.
Interesting. Unless she has to do it, in which case that's...
But in terms of showing off that you actually have skills, I think it's totally
valid. Yeah, that's totally good.
Which is the important part of the whole thing, is that I was easily able to get behind him. And so he can't just...
I'm a dwarf, that's not hard.
Yeah, but the speed and the accuracy of getting... It was just mainly she was using it to allow you to understand that you weren't with a bunch of idiots.
Isn't that actually kind of cool?
Which she probably appreciates.
What?
Which Marietta probably appreciates not being with a bunch of idiots, even though he still thinks you're a bunch of idiots.
But now that you told me that Chummer doesn't work on iPads, then I don't feel bad for not getting an iPad.
No.
No.
At least it's charged now. I
would look for Wolf... is it Hero Forge?
Yeah. Hero Forge was the one before that would actually make you so you have... picture of your character and everything else, and then also the stats and all that stuff.
Is it
you can put a picture on Chummer?
No.
I know, but he wants it to work on his Android.
Or the Android.
Yeah. Oh!
That's my big problem. I wish, if Chummer worked on Android, I wouldn't have an issue.
and honestly, Chummer, just from a player perspective, running like loading the, switching ammo, if you want to have like a really good combat character and you want to be like, you know what, I don't want to cheat, and I just want to switch ammo and know the numbers are right and all that kind of stuff, it is great. You click fire and it uses up the right number of ammo and all that stuff.
And you can load it. You can load different types of ammo in the different clips in the and then switch clips.
And you can load the dice. So you click on it and it rolls the dice for you.
Yeah.
It is awesome.
It really is awesome.
Can you imagine on this pad if I had that? Oh, boom. Oh, yeah. I hit or I miss.
It allows you to have as crazy, like... simulation-based play as you want without the complexity of it being simulation-based play and still feel like you're getting this different, you know, different results.
You know what proves to me is that I need Windows 10 phone
and it might
I need
be
a Windows
Wolf Lair.
10 pad.
Wolf Lair?
Wolf Lair.
Wolf?
That's what it teaches me.
Lair?
I...
Like Lair?
Wolf Lair. Like, yeah, like a place they sleep.
See, the problem is, like, I could get, like, a Windows 10 version of this, but this exact same thing in Windows 10
so
version...
Wolf Lair,
like,
so Wolf Lair, Hero Lab. There you go,
Hero Lab.
Yeah, Hero Lab, yeah. But even, like, a Windows 10 version of this would be so effing expensive. Because it'd probably be an i5 in there or something like that.
You're talking about $1,200.
Hero Lab does work with Shadow.
This was only $200.
It does?
It's cheap.
Hero Lab does?
Okay, that was cheap.
Yeah.
Here's a. This is wolflayer.com.
Yeah, I just don't know if they have tablet support. I know they have tablet support for viewing Pathfinder characters. So the.
I've used this company's army builder software for like Warhammer and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. That's pretty decent.
Layer was hit with bunkers.
Do they have all that?
Okay.
They have all that for Shadowrun though. They have the Shadowrun.
It says used for D&D, Pathfinder, Shadowrun, Mutants and Masterminds, D20.
Unfortunately, that is iPad.
Yeah, it's iPad.
We have stacks of iPads though.
That's true.
You could just use one, but we don't. We just don't own it. I don't think. Well, maybe we own it.
What?
I'm crazy. Hero Lab. If you look on the iPad, we might.
I'm fairly certain I own it on my PC.
But the thing is, I don't own the books for Shadowrun, for Hero Lab. And that's ultimately
why... Oh, you have to buy books for them?
That's what they do.
Mm.
So I...
But, I mean, it's good in a sense because then it gives money to the people who made the books. But if you already bought the books, it's bullshit. Which we have.
And I own, like, $60 worth of digital Pathfinder stat blocks for Hero Lab. Mm. But we don't play Pathfinder. And so, you know, whatever. But
so there is a Hero Lab character sheet thing for Android, but you have to copy over a bunch of crap.
Oh dear lord!
And I don't really know how well it works for Shadowrun. Or...
Yeah, I've looked up Shadowrun character creators on Android, and they have like three, but two of them are like utter crap, and then the third one works okay, but it's not great.
It's not on the phones. It's only on the tablets.
Yeah.
It looks pretty complex. It doesn't look lame.
Yeah, but it's not like Chummer, where it's like everything. Chummer will literally, like, you could, like, say, here's my future spouse, and it would pop out your new baby and everything, and then year one, year two, year three.
Yeah.
You could age your baby.
And they only, right now, they only have...
I actually own it.
Yeah, because I bought it. I'm pretty sure.
Game not installed.
Because I'm just crazy like that. But for Pathfinder, it's really good. For Shadowrun, it looks good, but it's only... The thing about Chummer is it has all the book support, right? So...
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
I hate using the software and then feeling bad about using books that aren't supported in the software, and then you're like, oh, I'll just handwrite it in, and then it's like, oh, it's junk.
No, that's the thing with Chummer. That's why it is awesome.
It is awesome. And it's awesome that Catalyst hasn't, like, taken them down or anything.
Now, what I'm concerned with, though, is why the fuck wouldn't they do it for all the systems? Like, it makes no sense. Why keep it on just one platform?
Chummer?
Yeah, it seems like it'd be very easy.
It's a GitHub project.
Yeah.
What's that?
That means the source code is free, and you would be welcome to download it and then program your own Android support. They want that. That's the purpose of it being on...
It's not some company that makes it. It's just a bunch of dudes who just said, hey, here's some crap we programmed for Shadowrun.
You know some sort of a dork that can do this for us?
It would be me if I didn't already have like a half dozen projects.
I'm talking about another dork. That's what
I don't.
Rich has already patched this version of Chummer.
Yeah,
that we're using.
Yeah, I know.
Because I just put page numbers everywhere.
Nice.
And I fixed Banshees, even though nobody ended up playing as Banshee. But
oh,
they actually fixed it already, though. They've actually already fixed a bunch of the things that I fixed, but I don't want to lose the page numbers, so I haven't updated.
Mm. Nice.
Well, and if there's no reason to update it, then there's no reason.
Updated rules.
Oh.
So I might update it.
Are there actually new rules?
Just save the code somewhere.
There is new books, like, pretty constantly. But...
No, I mean new rules, though.
Yeah, there's new rules in each new book.
Oh.
But, like, the last book I bought was Parazoology 2. It just came out, but it's for GMs. It's just critters. Actually, they're really good about having all kinds of cool stuff. Even the critter book, it's not like the monster manual. Mm-hmm. It actually has, not Parazoology 2, I mean, what book did I, Howling Shadows. Howling Shadows, they actually mix world knowledge and fiction throughout every couple chapters. So if you read the stories, you get a feeling for how these things are supposed to go. Like how the fiction is supposed to be.
I don't remember if it's in the main rule book or in the rigger handbook. Like there's an actual story of like a rigger just driving a truck, her rigger truck or whatever.
Uh-huh.
And then like all of a sudden there's a mission. And she has to kind of jump in on this mission and then how riggers work in this mission. And it kind of goes through it.
That's cool.
It's really good. Like, I would really recommend reading some of the fiction from like maybe Run and Gun or because that's probably more appropriate to like the Street Samurai or maybe
could
try Chrome Flesh Chrome Flesh just to me feels like it's not as solid as some of their other.
I think it was a different writer.
Yeah.
And a lot of their,
and it's not that they don't have fiction in there or whatever, but if everybody were to read their book, like their concept book, right? They have a book for coyotes. They have a book for Street Samurai. They have a book for medics.
Mm-hmm.
They have a book for mages. They have a book for deckers. They have a book for riggers. Right? If everybody read just a couple fiction stories in their concept book, everybody would bring their unique perspective that their like character type is supposed to have. And then if Steve just watched the Godfather trilogy like 3 or 4 times, he would bring his like concept he's bringing to the table. And
all I have to do is start watching 007.
You don't really have to watch the trilogy. You don't need to watch 3. 1 and 2 is fine.
So, like, what's the Street Samurai book called?
The Street Samurai? I don't know if it's the Street Samurai book, but I was thinking Chrome Flesh is the book.
No, because that's just, in general, that's just the Cyborg handbook.
Yeah,
but
isn't
that Street Samurai?
Run and Gun, I think, is more.
Well, and that's why I said Run and Gun
was
the other.
That's the one I need.
Well, there's also Run Faster, though, right?
Yeah, the, oh, run faster might be it too. I don't know. It's one of those.
I mean,
the
street samurai just
definitely the one.
They're just combat people, right? So
yeah, they're just combat monkeys.
Run and gun might be the best, but that's also weapon specialists. It's also bounty hunters, probably.
It's also operative spies.
The operative spies wing is the assassin's primer.
Oh, really? She didn't have anything from there.
No, I didn't. Well, because you just have the archetypes. Everybody has the archetypes, and then I just gave you spare stuff so that if you choose to customize, that's great. Also, what I was kind of hoping is I'm hoping some of the stuff that we do will bleed over into
the
Jason's
campaign.
Campus,
yeah, yeah.
Right? Because we're kind of doing a little bit of world building here. And
yeah, this is a lot of fun. I like it.
So anyone feel like going for a snack somewhere? Because I'm hungry.
It's Vegas, and we could do stuff. That's fine. All right, guys. That's probably a good point to
end it. I'm tired, and I want to go to bed. If you want to go somewhere and get something, I will go.
Thanks for coming here, Rich. And,
yeah.
Yeah. See everybody next week.
That was a lot of fun, guys. Talk to you later. Thanks, Jason. Thanks, Anthony.
Good night.
Bye.
Jason, make time for Vermintide this weekend.
Vermintide.
All right. Later.
Bye. Later.